Joining me now, former Vermont Governor and Dr. Howard Dean and Senator and Dr. John Barrasso of Wyoming. Let me start with the question I asked Brianna about the White House. You both have been in practice. What are your long-term concerns, if any, about the implementation of the Affordable Care Act?
Well, it's not going to be affordable. There's going to be sticker shock, number one. And number two, it's going to be harder for people to actually get what they wanted, which is the care they need from a doctor they want at lower cost. The president made a couple of promises, one with the exchanges, and he said it would be cheaper than a cell phone bill. And I don't expect a lot of people to be able to find something less than $71 a month on the exchanges. People are going to be paying more. And he said you can keep the doc, if you have your doctor and you like your doctor, you can keep your doctor. We're seeing all across the country exchanges that trying to get the price down have had to exclude many doctors.
Yeah, Governor Dean, we are seeing, it really does seem to me, it depends on what state you're in, because this is very hard to keep track of, because in some states, some people are saying, oh, mine will be much lower. In other states, it appears will be much higher.
So,
long-term, what are you worried about?
In the vast majority of states, in fact, the premiums are significantly lower, including mine. I mean, really lower, like 40% in some cases. So I would disagree with Senator Dr. Barrasso on that. I think there are going to be some glitches. As you know, I wasn't a big supporter of this bill, but now that we're at D-Day, I'm looking forward to it. I really do think it's going to change things, and it's going to change them in the private sector. These people are going to go on the exchange, and they're going to get private insurance. That's what this does. So I don't buy this. Doctors aren't going to accept this. Doctors always have trouble accepting. Some doctors don't accept Medicare. But this is going to work. It's a sensible solution. There are going to be glitches. None of them so far are major. We'll see how this. The big one is the federal exchange, where all the folks who refused, governors who refuse to become part of their own state exchange are now in a big 33-state federal exchange, and that's what they've got to do right, and we'll have to see how it works. But I'm very optimistic, and I think it's going to be good for the public, and I think when they see what this looks like, this debate that we're having, which is outrageous, is going to look really stupid.
Well, you go ahead with the outrageous debate.
I think the exchanges are being held together right now with duct tape and chicken wire. We're not sure what's going to work.
They haven't even started yet.
The efforts to try, we see many states, even the governor's home state of Vermont has had problems. They're not going to be able to accept payments online. Oregon is backing down. Other states are. The District of Columbia last week said, hey, we're not ready. Huge ability for fraud, for identity theft on the exchanges. The bottom line is, I think it's not just an issue of will doctors still see patients. Patients are going to have a hard time finding a doctor to take care of them under these exchanges. In New Hampshire, where Howard was on Monday giving a speech, we know that there's an uproar because the Anthem Blue Cross Blue Shield is excluding 10 of the 28 hospitals in
that state from the exchange, and pediatricians
aren't going to be able to take care of kids they've been taking care of.
That does need to be fixed, but that's the fault of the New Hampshire state government, not the fault of Obamacare. Look, we're going to see. I don't think the sky is falling. We've been through much more. This is what they said about Medicare. The right winger said this about Medicare. The sky was going to fall. Nothing was going to happen. It was going to be awful. And it's one of the most popular programs in the country.
You know, we are seeing what they call this, what concierge doctors or
that was happening long before this ever started.
Exactly, but will we see more? And these are doctors who say, forget insurance. If you can come and pay me, you know, write me a check.
The reason you're not going to see a lot of that is there's not much of a market for it. There are a couple of those in Vermont. There's more in New York and L.A. It's just not that. Look, this is what's going to happen. People are going to have a different system. The glitch in Vermont and D.C. is a minimal glitch. You can sign up for health care now. It doesn't matter if you can pay for it today or November 1st because it doesn't go into effect until January 1st. I've looked at this stuff inside out because I've looked at it from the point of view of somebody who didn't like what they did in the beginning. I actually wanted a Medicare, a public option, so we could sign up for something we knew what it was and understood it more easily. But we are where we are. This is going to be a very positive thing for the public. And I think you saw the desperation in Kathy McMorris's voice is about the fact that they realize that once this goes into effect, people are going to like it. And the right wing, very conservative, let's not spend another dime people, are going to be stuck supporting another entitlement, which is really unpopular.
This law is unworkable. It's unpopular. It is unaffordable for us as a nation. It's hurting jobs. It's hurting the economy. And now what I'm hearing, and I was at a health fair in Lovell, Wyoming yesterday, it is unfair. Someone said to me, why is it that the president is going to give my boss a one-year delay, The bosses are getting a delay, but the workers are not. And we need a delay in the individual mandate.
Hold that thought. We're going to come back with the two of you.